both APM set and TSM set. So the first question which I'm going to discuss is from stoichiometry, like how many moles of ammonia are produced by 5 moles of hydrogen. So if you see the equation, nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen gas to give ammonia gas. So just see that 3 moles is giving 2 moles. So 3 moles of hydrogen is giving 2 moles of nitrogen ammonia. 2 moles of ammonia. So 1 mole will give 2/3. So 5 moles will give 2/3 × 5. That means 10/3. That is 3.33 moles of ammonia. That means if you have 5 moles of hydrogen gas, you will get 3.3 moles of ammonia gas. As we know, from stoichiometry, we have done this. Second, if you are given ethene and restricted with hydrogen, it forms ethane. As you know, this is hydrogenation and it occurs in presence of catalysts like nickel, palladium, platinum. So what you need to do, they are asking that you have to produce 550 gram of ethane. So how much gram of ethylene is required? Very simple question. First you find the molar mass. So molar mass will be 1 mole is giving 1 mole. So 1 mole is 28 gram, and this 1 mole is 30 gram. So 28 gram is giving 30 gram. So 30 gram is produced from 28 gram. So 1 gram will be produced from 28/30. So 50 gram can be produced by 28/50 × 50. So this is cancelled. So if you solve this, this will be more than 28, because 5/3 is 1.66. So it will be 46.6 gram of ethylene is required to form 50 gram of ethylene. So this all question appeared in 2020. Do keep it in mind. Third question is a beautiful question. They are saying, with reference to redox property, you have to remember the hydrogen peroxide. So the trick you remember is O-Rabba trick. It is oxidizing agent. It is a reducing agent. And it is also a bleaching agent. Keep this in mind. For solving question, and you have to know the oxidizing reducing nature of hydrogen peroxide with certain equation, that is redox. So let's see, 2Fe2+ + 2H+ + H2O2 give 2Fe3+ + 2H2O. So if you see this reaction here is Fe2+ 2Fe3+, that means it is undergoing oxidation. Hydrogen peroxide oxygen is -1 and here oxygen is -2, so it is undergoing reduction. That means it is a redox reaction. It is a redox reaction. Here, since it is gaining electrons, so it is oxidizing agent, and it is undergoing. It is losing electrons, so it is a reducing agent. Next, MnO4 - 2MnO4 - 6H+ + 5H2O2 give 2Mn2+ + 8H2O + 5O2. So if you see this, this is +7. This is +7. And this is +2. So +7 to +2, it is reduction, and it's -1 to 0, it is oxidation. So it is also a redox reaction. So involving hydrogen peroxide, here it is undergoing, so it is a reducing agent, here it is an oxidizing agent. As we know, KMnO4 is a strong oxidizing agent. Third reaction, 2Fe2+ + H2O2 give 2Fe3+ + 2OH-. So here oxygen is -1, here oxygen is -2. So from here to here reduction, and from here to here oxidation. So here it is also acting as an oxidizing agent. So from these all equations, we say that hydrogen peroxide is acting here as oxidizing agent, here as reducing agent, and here as oxidizing agent. So these are all redox reactions involving hydrogen peroxide. Next question, which I want to discuss, is equivalent weight of KMnO4. in acidic medium. KMnO4 in acidic medium. Acidic medium. So if you see that this half reaction is like this. So here it is plus 7, here it is plus 2. So you, as you know, 5 electron has to be added. Here 4 oxygen, so 4 water molecule we will add. And here 8 H plus will be added. So equivalent weight equal to molecular weight by N factor. So here N factor is the total number of electron gained. So M by 5 is the answer. So this you can easily find. You, if you know the KMnO4 molecular mass, 158, 158 by 5 will become, it will become 31.6 grams. So keep this in mind. So this was asked in MCET previous year. Next is, you have been given an empirical formula of a compound. Empirical formula is given to you, that is C2H5O, and the vapor density is given to you, 45. So as you know, molecular weight equal to 2 into vapor density, so it is 90, and the empirical formula mass is 24 plus 5 plus 16, 21, so that is 45. So N is equal to molecular weight by empirical formula weight. So it is 90 by 45, that is 2. So molecular formula will be, molecular formula will be N into empirical formula. So 2 into C2H5O, that means answer will be C4H10O. This will be the answer. So this way you can solve question related to empirical formula and molecular formula. Now seeing few questions from atomic structure. Two series of spectral lines of atomic hydrogen, which do not belong to infrared region. It's a very easy question, infrared region. From hydrogen spectrum, so you can easily figure out that you know that Lyman is in UV region and Balmer is in visible region. So these two are not in infrared region. So you can just search from the options given. So answer will be Lyman and Balmer. Next. Which activities can be compared to the concept of quantization? Can be compared to concept of quantization. So there are options like a car is traveling on the road, apple is falling from the tree, a person can stand on any step of a staircase. So a person can stand on any step of a staircase. So this is an example of concept of quantization. Next. So they have given the degeneracy in the hydrogen level of energy is minus RH by 16. So you know that energy equal to minus RH by N square. So you just have to compare this. So minus RH by N square is equal to minus RH by 16. So this is, so here just you have to focus on this. So N square is equal to 16. So N is equal to 4. This you have to keep in mind. So degeneracy they are asking. In this question. So 4 is not the answer. What you have to do? So N is 4. So it can be 4S, 4P, 4D, 4F. So 4S means L is equal to 0, so M is equal to 0, L is equal to 1, ML is equal to minus 1, 0, plus 1. So here one orbital is there, here three orbital is there, here five orbital is there, here seven, five, 12. So it is 16. So 16 will be the degeneracy level. Degenerate orbital means having equal energy. Degenerates, total degeneracy. So one degeneracy for 4s, three will be for 4p, five will be for 4d, and seven will be for 4f. So this way 16 degeneracy level will be there. Next question. Next question is, n is equal to 1, l is equal to 0, m, l is equal to plus 1, ms is equal to plus r, minus r. This is option 1. Option 2 is n is equal to 1, l is equal to 1, ml is equal to 0, ms is equal to plus r. See, n is equal to 3, l is equal to 1, ml is equal to 0, ms equal to plus r. D, n is equal to 3, l is equal to 3, ml is equal to 0, minus 3, sorry, and ms equal to plus 1. It is saying that which is not possible, which is not possible, which set is possible. So this is not possible because if L is 0, ML cannot be plus 1. Okay, here these two cannot be equal. So principal quantum number azimuthal cannot be equal. So this is also not possible. And this is possible. So this is possible. But here N and L are equal. So this is also not possible. So only possible is C. So if C is possible. Next question. They are asking maximum number of electrons. So maximum number of electrons. So n is equal to 4 and l is equal to 3. So n is equal to 4, l is equal to 4f. 4f. So so 4f, as we know, it has 7 orbitals. And you know that one orbital has 2 electrons, so 7 into 2, so 14 electrons are the answer. Next question, you can think from chemical bonding. So you can check my videos on bond order. Bond order questions have come. HE bond order will be 0. DE bond order will be 0, Ne2 bond order will be 0, He2 plus bond order is 0.5, hydrogen bond order is 1, O2 bond order is 2, N2 bond order is 3, nitrogen has triple bond. So keep all these things in mind, and you have a mountain formula which you can check in my channel. Beautiful concept, just remember those, you'll get one question. They've asked hybridization of carbon and oxygen in carbon dioxide. So this will be sp because it has 2 pi bond here, and oxygen will be sp2 because it has only 1 pi bond. So this next, they have asked this compound they have given, CH triple bond, C double bond, CH2. So they have written this like this, 1, 2, 3, they are asking the hybridization. So one will be sp, 2 will be sp2, and 3 will be sp, because here pi electrons are on both sides, pi bonds. So this is an important question. Next, they have asked question related to diborate. So as you know, it has a banana bond. So based on this question will be asked hybridization. So sp3, you know that the structure is very beautiful structure it has. So it has like 4 terminal, two center, two electron bonds. These are, so two center, two electron bonds are 4. These are the banana bond which are formed by, so it is 3 center, 2 electron bonds are 2. So these are, but hybridization is sp3. Keep this in mind. These are terminal bonds. These are 2 electron, 2 center, 2 electron bond, and these are 3 center, 2 electron bond. Next question, what they are asking is like, if you have BF3, so they will have shape, so it will be trigonal planar. As you know, the hybridization is sp3, so it will be trigonal planar. CH4 will be sp3, it will be tetrahedral. Next, they have asked like ClF3, as you know, it is sp3d and it will be T-shaped. So these are the common questions they are asking. Ammonium ion will be tetrahedral, sp3 tetrahedral. Keep in mind ammonia they have asked, ammonia is also sp3, but one lone pair is there, so that makes it trigonal pyramidal. So these are the likely questions which are coming for your exam, so do prepare nicely, student. Next question which they have asked is AlCl3. AlCl3 they have asked. In hydrous condition, it is ionic. And in aqueous condition, anhydrous it will be covalent. And in aqueous, it will become ionic. So keep this in mind about AlCl3. Next, keep in mind the lithium chloride has both ionic property also and covalent property is due to small size of, so Li plus small size, smaller the cation, higher the covalent character, and that is explained by Fajans rule. So keep this in mind. A smaller cation has more covalent character than a larger cation. Keep in mind that lone pair repulsion is more than lone pair bond pair repulsion. Bond pair repulsion. Okay, this is from Whisper theory. So this is also important for your exam. HCOF4 is square pyramidal. You can decide on the basis of Whisper theory. So if you see the structure of HCF4, it will be like this. Oxygen will be formed with double bond and one lone pair will be there. So it's square pyramidal. Next question is HCO3 hybridization they are asking. So it is sp3 and it is pyramidal. It is pyramidal like ammonia. Only difference is that oxygen will be formed with double bond. It is pyramidal. Next. SF6 is octahedral. SF6 is octahedral. Keep in mind that NiCO4 is tetrahedral. These are the questions that have been asked. NiCl4 2- is tetrahedral. This is also tetrahedral. But keep in mind that NiCN4 2- is square planar. So this much I have covered, student. I will be doing it more in my next video. Do prepare all these questions. These are all very important questions. All the best for your MCAT exam. I hope this is helpful. Thanks for watching.